What movie was better than the book and why? Might be unpopular, but I think The Princess Bride. I found Buttercup's character way worse in the book. Even to a point where I was like, okay, dude, cut ties, you're better off without her in the movie. I never feel that really. Shawshank Redemption. It was part of a four-part novella released by Stephen King. The story was very short but very well written. I just feel like the movie really captured the spirit of the story and gave some depth to the characters. Plus, the acting was great. Who Framed Roger Rabbit? The book was supposed to be written as film noir, but it ends up as a disjointed mess. The characters are there, but they have none of the charm of the movie. Eddie isn't a good man. Who's ruining his life with booze after the loss of his brother? He's a drunk asshole. Just because Roger is dead, etc. The plot is also different. The movie took the idea of humans and toons interacting and went in a completely different direction. Jaws. I think Arrival was better. And that's coming from someone who really liked the short story. The movie is just better at telling that story overall. The aversion of 12 Angry Men. I found the book boring, but the film resonates even decades after I watched it. Jaws. Because everyone in the novel is a terrible person. And a lot of the tension in the film is removed because the guys hunting the shark just get to go home every night. American Psycho. The movie did a fine job portraying how insane he was. There were passages in the book that almost made me put it down and stop reading it. Just too much. Pure shock value. Call Me by Your Name. The movie was a beautiful study of silences. In the book, you experienced every thought going through a 17-year-old boy's head. It was manic. In the movie, you had to rely on Chalamet's performance to understand what was going on in his head. Fight Club. The book had a better ending, but it was written in such bizarre style it was a chore to read. And it's a short book too. It Chapter 1 was great. Plus it didn't end with all the kids banging Bev like the Stephen King novel. So it gets my vote. Schindler's List. The book was almost unreadable. Then again, I'm a dumbass. Ready Player One was simultaneously better and worse than the book. It was worse because the movie's puzzle plot made little sense. You're telling me no one in the history of the billion-dollar puzzle thought to go backwards? Movie? But it was better because it cut out a lot of the neckbeard shit in the book. Like how the protagonist spends 3 pages explaining differences in Atari games to someone. And then everyone claps because of how awesome it was. Stardust. I forgot my why. The book was somewhat dark and dreary as I remember it. But the movie is a brilliant, fanciful adventure. The Silence of the Lambs. It was incredibly drawn out at times, and they were right to cut a lot of it out of the movie. The author also feels the need to describe the hell out of everything, and it gets tedious to read. Jurassic Park. The movie created more suspense than I think was possible in the book. The build-up to the first time we see the T-Rex wasn't quite as intense on the page as it was on the screen. Holes. I don't know if it was better, but damn, the movie did the book justice. One of my favorite childhood books and movies. Slumdog Millionaire. I feel that it's somewhat cheating in regards to this question for films like Slumdog Millionaire, Forrest Gump, and Jojo Rabbit, because they aren't even trying to be faithful adaptations. They take a lot of liberties and go in a lot of different directions than the source material. So whether it's even the same story as the book Q&A on which it's based is debatable. But I certainly enjoyed it more. The Princess Bride. Jaws. Because the book is fucking awful. With an idiotic subplot about Hooper and Brody's wife. And also the Mafia. For some fucking reason. First Blood and the Warriors. Just here to say that if anyone says Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, I am going to ban him from the internet. The Martian. Mainly because the visuals were amazing and it made the story so much better to be able to see everything. The Godfather. I like the book, but the film is phenomenal. The Prestige again. Good book. Phenomenal film. Catching Fire was so well done and not as boring as the book. Jojo Rabbit was better than Caging Skies. The book was so goddamn bleak that it probably wouldn't have been adapted otherwise. The Godfather. I think a lot of people can agree with that. Horton, here's a who. There's a lot more character put into all the people in Whoville, and Jim Carrey kills it as Horton. The story is accomplished in an effective way that still retains the moral and overall feel of the original. And the movie is allowed to flesh out the world in a way that Dr. Seuss didn't. To those of you who say, but it's so short and would have been really hard to mess up improving on a book like that, I submit any of the other adaptations of Dr. Seuss's work made in the last 25 years. Wanted. And you may be asking yourself, but isn't that movie not very good? And you'd be correct. It's not. The comic that it's based on, however, is god awful. The movie changes so much about the book that it's hardly the same story. But it removes the weirdo rape fantasies present throughout the comic that seem more like punchlines than character building. It's a great concept squandered by Mark Miller's juvenile edgelord writing. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Matilda, the character, was a hell of a lot more likable in the film than the book. Well, don't know if comics are valid, but a lot of MCU movies are better than the comics. At least, you know, they are consistent. Kinda. Diary of a Wimpy Kid. They rearranged a lot, pulled things from multiple books for one movie and made it so the main character actually has some growth. In the books, he remains the same unchanged sociopath who learns nothing. Nobody better say Percy Jackson or we gon' have beef. Roots. If that counts. I personally like watching things rather than reading, so maybe that's why. Debbie Does Dallas. How to Train Your Dragon. In the books, the dragons are little and caught to fish and do other chores. Girl with a Dragon Tattoo is pretty close to beating the book. Edit, and I mean the Rooney Mara one. To be honest, most books I've read are better. So much so, that I won't watch a film before I have read the book if it's based on one. The Green Mile by Stephen King. The film was definitely better than the book for me. The entire LOTR series. I'm not sure why, since it's been well over a decade since I read the LOTR books. But I found reading through them to be a chore, as opposed to the movies, which in my opinion, are some of the greatest films ever made. Blade Runner. The novel was good, but the movie perfected the tone, and quite honestly I thought Deckard was written better for the film. Not a movie, but so far I think The Expanse TV series has been a bit better than the books. The show has had the benefit of developing characters earlier that don't stand out in the books until later in the series. And they're some of the best character a Queen Bees and Wannabes, mostly known by its movie adaptation name as Mean Girls. I mean, they're basically nothing alike, but the book is supposed to be a self-help book. Annihilation. The book had a slow pace that didn't create the same atmosphere as the movie. The Mist. Even Stephen King agreed. Les Miserables BBC miniseries. The Princess Bride, the unabridged version of the book, droned on needlessly at times. It was an interesting read, but the movie was an immense joy. Read the book once, but watch the movie numerous times. Kingsman is better than the comic, mainly because they did follow the comic all that much. Captain America, Civil War. The comic event that it is based on doesn't make a ton of sense. It misses out on a lot of opportune nights. And Tony Stark is straw-manned. The movie makes all the character motivations clear and presents both sides equally. This is a great example of improving the execution of an interesting idea with a second crack. Batman, Under the Red Hood, is another example of this. 50 Shades of Grey, just because it couldn't possibly have been any worse. Not a movie, but the TV show Dexter was better than the book. At least at first. Went off the rails eventually. Return of the King. I loved the first two LOTR books, but about one-third way into Return of the King it switches to Frodo and Sam's point of view, and it becomes a mundane slog to get through to the end. Not much happens, and it's mostly Frodo and Sam complaining about how hard their quest is in climbing Hill's witch begins to feel really redundant pretty quickly. If it swapped between Frodo's quest and Aragorn's story like many modern books do in similar situations, it wouldn't feel so bad and awkwardly paced. I read the Metro series and it was a bit difficult to understand the wording in a couple of the books. Sometimes you would have to reread a couple pages to figure out what the hell was going on. I then played the game, which was pretty good, and then reread the book and I could put stuff together easier. Fight Club, American Psycho, Misery, Shawshank, Shining, Doctor Sleep, Gone Girl, Green Mile, The Dead Zone, To Kill a Mockingbird, Forrest Gump, Schindler's List, Godfather, The Disaster Artist, Trainspotting, Little Women, LOTR, No Country for Old Men, Goodfellas, Room, The Social Network, The Exorcist, Psycho, Silence of the Lambs, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Perks of Being a Wallflower, 2001, A Space Odyssey, Shop Girl. I love Steve Martin, but the book was a mess. I loved the movie. He and Claire Danes were magic. To All the Boys I've Loved Before. I watched the movie and loved it so much that I bought the book trilogy. The movie is beautiful, but reading the book made me realize that it's the cinematography and acting that make the movie so good. The actual plotline is really cheesy. The books are also written in a really simple way for a much younger audience. Forrest Gump was way better than the book it was based on. This is my opinion. All you diehard LOTR fans, keep this in mind. But the LOTR films are better than the books. This is purely an entertainment, as the books go on huge tangents about the world, which makes sense, as Tolkien's main purpose for the books was to present his world, which can be boring and off-putting unless you're really into the history of pipeweed. The films filter most of this and changes stuff to make it better, for example replacing an orc with a troll in Moria and making Aragorn more relatable by giving him an internal conflict about whether he deserves to be king. The Lovely Bones. It's been a while since I read the book, but I remember thinking the movie was better. Everything is illuminated. The movie was so sweet and made me cry. The book was hard to follow. Less than Zero and American Psycho. Bret Ellis's style is shit, but they both translated well to the screen. Apocalypse Now was infinitely superior to Heart of Darkness. American Psycho, mainly because I really liked Christian Bale's performance and how they talked. The book was too gory for me. Dogma, felt the Bible wasn't as funny, and Where Was Alan Rickman? Sorry, not really to be that person, but A Song of Ice and Fire is such a hard read. And yeah, I dislike the ending of Gut just like everyone else, but emo, it's more palatable that way than reading page after page about how Sansa thinks Joffrey is so perfect or how much Tyrion enjoyed his daily blowjob. It, you know why, The Mist by Stephen King. All due to the ending. King left it open-ended in the book. The movie gives it a finality that left me aghast when I first saw it. Pretty sure even King has admitted he liked the movie ending better. Both were utterly atrocious, but I'd have to say the 50 Shades of Grey film was better than the book, because you didn't have to listen to her inner monologue full of "oh my" and "my inner goddess did a backflip," etc. Ugh. Die Hard, John Carter, Martian Tales Trilogy. So much of that book was John's in deep shit, but now he's not my sister's keeper. The ending of the book was so fucking stupid it almost made me not watch the movie. It was like the author wanted to just have a shocking ending instead of an ending that actually makes sense in the narrative. Both Neil Gaiman books, Coraline and Stardust, loved the movies but hated the books. I just don't think he writes characters well. Arrival, no disrespect to Ted Chiang, as Stories of Your Life is great, but the movie allows for a much deeper portrayal of the moral dilemma. The Hunt for Red October, Shawshank Redemption, I, Robot, although the two are vastly different, really only sharing the title, I personally enjoy the movie more. Shawshank Redemption, the movie Fletch, wisely, left out a fact that he sleeps with a 14-year-old prostitute who overdoses and whose body he then buries on the beach. The Devil Wears Prada. The book was horrendous. Gone Girl. They left out all the tedious scenes from the book and focused on the important and exciting ones.